Hello students, welcome to Economicspedia. So today we are going to discuss numericals on the topic of compensating variation and equivalent variation. Now in this session we will mainly be focusing by taking up a single question covering the whole arena, that is the compensating as well as the equivalent variation. So as you can see, a question written on the board, but before that let me also tell you that if you have any kind of problem with the theory of compensating variation and equivalent variation, please follow our video. You can see this card over here. Click on the card and get to know the theory. You can also find the link below in the description box. And let us know if you have any kind of problem from that session. So, starting with today's session, here is a question. Let me read it out for you. So we have a utility function they have given us, that is u equal to x1 to the power half and x2 to the power half. Along with that, they have also mentioned the initial income, that is equal to 100, and the initial prices of the two goods, that is P1 and P2, are equal to 1. In the final scenario, we have that the price of x1 has increased from P1 to P1 dash, and P1 dash is nothing but 2. So P1 dash is greater than P1. And they have finally asked us to find the EV and CV. Okay. So we have a utility function. We have the final income. We have the prices. That means we know the budget constraint. All we have to find the initial consumption bundle, because that is really going to help us in order to find this compensating and equivalent variation. So before getting into this compensating and equivalent variation, let's solve for the optimal bundles of consumption in the initial scenario. So for that, we will be taking the help of a Lagrangian. So let me denote the Lagrangian as L. And here we have our utility function plus of lambda. We have, okay, so let us for the initial case, let us find the final consumption bundle in terms of a general variables. That is here income I am representing as M. And the P1 is the price of X1, and here P1 is equal to P2, that is equal to 1. They have already given us. Okay, so time for the budget constraint. So here the budget constraint is M minus of X1 P1 minus of X2 P2, right? Now, the FOC. So del L del x1, this is half, x2, x1, whole to the power half, right? And here we have lambda, p1 equal to 0. So this is equation 1. The second FOC is x1 by x2 to the power half, lambda p2, this is my second FOC, and the third FOC is with respect to the Lagrangian multiplier. So here we have the budget constraint, and this is my equation number 3. I hope you have copied the whole question, because as I'm short of space, I need that. So I'm erasing the question area. So from 1 and 2, what we can see is we have half, x2 to the power half and x1 to the power minus half, and we are doing 1 divided by 2. Okay, so here x1 to the power half and x2 to the power minus half, and this is equal to p1 and p2. From equation 1 and 2 we get this. Okay, we get this. Let's see what we can cancel out. The half and half is gone, and we ultimately have x2 by x1 equal to P1 by P2, right? So from here we can write P1 X1 equal to P2 X2. Now using this equation in FOC number 3. So using that equation in equation number 3. So equation number 3 looks like this. X2 P2, right? And let's say equation number 4. So substituting or using equation number 4, we can write, so here we have twice of X1 P1 and therefore the optimal bundle is X1 star equal to M by 2 P1. In the same way, if I substitute for the other one, so we have this X2 P2 and I am substituting for X2 P2, so I am having the another optimal bundle X2 star as M by 2 P1 or another one as X2 star is equal to M by 2 P2. Right? Now from the question that you have noted, you can see the values of income and the prices were given. So all I am doing is substituting them. So we can write the initial consumption bundle, it is what? The income, let's say X1 star, the income was 100 and the price of P1 was 1. So this is divided by 2. So X1 star is 50. And similarly, we can also say that X2 star is also 50, right? So this we have not yet entered the compensating variation or equivalent variation area. Before that we have find out the initial consumption bundle, that is before the price change. So we have, now we will be going one by one. So before moving to that, some of the important thing that we need to take account before entering into the compensating and equivalent variation area, that is these two final consumption bundle, these two consumption bundle before any price change we need this. Okay, so these are the few information that we require from the previous section that we have just done. Now let's move towards the compensating variation portion. One by one we will be moving. So first start with the compensating variation. Here we have a situation where there is a price increase in one of the commodities. So, and the compensating variation talks about what happens in the final scenario. So in the final scenario, the prices of X1, the price of X1 has increased. So we can say that in this situation, in order to maintain the utility level of the consumer constant or unchanged, we need to give some amount of money to the consumer in the final scenario so that the consumer's satisfaction level remains unchanged. So here the compensating variation represents the willingness to accept. And because of that, we are going to solve accordingly. But before that, let us take the income under this compensating variation as small m. Okay, now, so these are the two demand functions that we have. So we can say that X1 star, and from the question, in the question that they have mentioned us that the price of X1 has increased from 1 to 2. So here, the only thing that is going to change is the value of P1 from 1 to 2. So here into 2, that is X1 star is equal to M by 4. And what will be X2 star? The income here is small m and there is no change in P2, that is it is equal to 1. So here divided by 2. So it remains m by 2. Okay, so these are the demand functions under compensating variation. When there is a price change, okay, in the final scenario, these are the two demand functions. Now, we have the utility function as x1 to the power half and x2 to the power half. And these are the demand function. And compensating variation talks about the situation where his final consumption level will be such that his satisfaction level remains same or remains constant as it was in the initial scenario. Now, the final demand functions are these two. So these two's utility has to be equated with the utility level when the price was unchanged. That is, when the consumption bundle was 50,50. What I'm trying to say is m by 4 to the power half into m by 2 to the power half. This is the final utility level after the change in the prices. It has to be equal to the initial level of utility. The consumption bundle in the initial scenario was 50,50. Okay, so this is the whole situation, and now after solving this equation, we can find the value of m as 141. So what does this m with the value of 141 actually implies? This says that when there will be a change in the price of any one of the commodity, here that is X1, the consumer, in order to have his original level of satisfaction, he needs to be given this much amount of money. He needs this much amount of money for that. Now, in the question that they have mentioned, the initial income was 100. So, we have got the value of small m as 141 and capital M, that is the initial income, the original income of the consumer, it has been given as 100. Therefore, we can say the equivalent variation is equal to 41. So, this much amount needs to be given to the consumer in order to have his original level of satisfaction. Now, let's find out the equivalent variation. Let's solve for the EV. So here again, the important things that are required, I have just written them again. That is x1 star, x2 star, the thing that we have obtained. And this is the initial consumption bundle, that is 50,50. And these are the values that it was given in the question. So, equivalent variation here implies is a situation in the initial scenario, so that when there will be finally an increase in the price in the final situation, the consumer's utility level remains constant or unchanged. Right? Now, so equivalent variation talks about what will happen in the initial scenario when there is no change in the prices. So, here the initial equilibrium represents the willingness to pay. Yes, the willingness to pay. That means here in the equivalent variation, the money will be taken away from the consumers in the form of a lump sum tax or any other form. So that in the initial situation, if the consumer left out with a lesser amount of money in his hand, so this implies that in the final scenario, when there will actually be an increase in the prices, which again means a reduction in the final income, these are the two situations in which the utility or the satisfaction of the consumer remains constant. Okay, so here the equivalent variation implies the willingness to pay. Right? So let's talk about equivalent variation. Again, here I am taking the income as small m. Now, we know that equivalent variation is the scenario when the consumer is adjusted with his income in such a way that his utility level is the same, that will happen as in the final scenario. So, in order to find the equivalent variation, we need to equate the demand functions when the prices was 1,1, that is the initial scenario, with the demand equations when there will be a final change in the prices, right? So, when the prices actually change, that is P1 has increased to P2. So, in the final scenario, the demand functions, let's say X1 star dash is equal to M by 2 into 2, right? Because the price has increased and M is here 100 divided by 4, so that is 25. X1 star is 25. And what is X2 star? So here nothing is changed, so this remains 50. Therefore, I'm writing X1 star dash and X2 star dash. Here it is equal to 25,50. This is the final demand functions after there is a change in the prices. Okay? So, in order to obtain the equivalent variation, we need to equate these things. So, M by 2 into to the power half divided by M by 2 to the power half, which has to be equated with the final demand functions. So here 25 to the power half and 50 to the power half. Okay. And from here, if you solve, you can find the value of M as 70. Now, in the equation that they, in the question only, they have mentioned that the income is 100. And here, my income under equivalent variation is 70. So, what does this imply? This implies that in the initial scenario, when there is no change in the prices of the commodities, the consumer can have the final consumption bundle at a price of, at an income of 70 rupees. He does not need 100 rupees. Got it? So here the equivalent variation is 70 minus 100. So that is minus of 30. So this minus implies that he is willing to give away the money or willing to pay. So this much amount of money needs to be taken away from the consumer in order to maintain his utility level remains constant in the final scenario as well. Okay, so this is how you need to solve the compensating variation and equivalent variation numericals. And this is one of the examples that we have done. And if you have any kind of queries related to this session of today's or any other sessions from Economicspedia, or if you have any of your queries that needs to be sorted out, please don't hesitate to contact us through our official mail ID. And don't forget to like the sessions and subscribe to the channel, because your contribution really matters to us. And this shows that how much you support us. So that's all for today's session. See you in the next one. Thank you.